Jennifer Ortham, and I'm celebrating from San Jose, California.
I'm watching from Paris, France.
In our lovely campus in Pasadena.
I'm from Northern California.
I'm calling from Ann Arbor, Michigan.
I'm in Hsinchu, Taiwan.
From Pasadena, California.
From Chicago, Illinois.
I'm watching from Orange County, California.
We're celebrating in Rockville, Maryland.
I'm celebrating in Pasadena, California.
I'm celebrating from Katz.
From Pasadena.
From Marin County, California.
I'm celebrating in Chicago.
I'm watching from Pasadena.
Pasadena, California.
From Palo Alto, California.
We're celebrating in Gwangju, Korea.
We join each other for the Institute's 127th commencement ceremony from locations far and wide. I am Thomas Rosenbaum, president of Caltech, here in Beckman Auditorium on campus. Thank you, students, your families and friends, faculty members, trustees, staff and alumni, for gathering today to cheer the accomplishments of our newest graduates. Graduates, your creativity, your strength of character, and your will to succeed in spite of the pandemic evidence themselves in the success we celebrate with you today. You bore disruption and grief with resilience and grace. With your faculty mentors and fellow scholars, you have managed to stay connected and to open new connections, forging new pathways to learning. As you demonstrate your commitment to discovery and to creating a better world, you instantiate the best of Caltech and influence our future. As we celebrate your achievements, we also realize that this is just the beginning. We look forward to your successes as Caltech alums as you head off to new adventures. It is now my pleasure to introduce the chair of the Caltech Board of Trustees, Dr. David Lee.
Graduates, on behalf of the Board of Trustees, congratulations. Today we celebrate your extraordinary accomplishments and express our gratitude for the support provided by your families and friends. Together, you have triumphed over a year of unprecedented societal and personal challenges. You navigated the hardship of a pandemic and grappled with questions of science and engineering as issues of social justice came powerfully into focus. Historic challenges often give rise to historic achievements. This year was no exception. You admirably advanced Caltech's mission to create knowledge for the ages and to benefit society with practical solutions to our most pressing concerns. Caltech research groups continue to apply their knowledge, some turning their creativity and tenacity to help combat the COVID-19 pandemic. Many of these efforts were done with support from the American Institute for Translational Research. As ever, we venture towards new horizons through accomplishments that include the opening of the Tan Chiao and Creasy Chen Neuroscience Research Building and the landing of the Mars Perseverance rover on Jezero crater. As part of the Mars 2020 mission, the Ingenuity Mars helicopter recently became the first aircraft in history to complete a powered, controlled flight on another planet, a feat that was first given lift by Caltech Center for Autonomous Systems. During this past year, we engaged in critical self-reflection and discussions on the Institute's past and its future. Led by the Black scientists, engineers of Caltech, and other members of the Caltech community, Caltech reaffirmed and extended its commitment to diversity, equity, inclusion, and accessibility. As part of these efforts, the Board of Trustees approved recommendations to remove from campus buildings and honors of the names of historical figures that were associated with the eugenics movement. This is an important step toward realizing Caltech's aspiration to become a community in which talented individuals from all backgrounds may thrive to their full potential and contribute to the Institute's mission of research and education. Though this occasion marks the completion of your degree programs, your journeys continue. You are equipped with fearlessness to pursue novel lines of inquiry. You are prepared with the rigor and imagination to address whatever challenges you may face. You have the perspective to reflect on your contributions against the backdrop of a complex world. We look forward to your creation of things we have not yet imagined. Congratulations, fellow alumni. May you cherish your Caltech experience for the rest of your lives, as I cherish mine.
Thank you, Dr. Lee. It is now my honor to welcome to this virtual stage our keynote speaker, Norm Augustine. Norm is a pioneer in the aerospace industry, famously serving as CEO of Lockheed Martin Corporation. He has translated that experience into broad advocacy for science and technology, and for the benefit of the country as a trusted governmental advisor and author of landmark studies. He is most famous in some circles as the author of the so-called Augustine's Laws, the data-based aphorisms named after him. For example, law number 15, the last 10% of performance generates 1/3 of the cost and 2/3 of the problems. Somehow, Mr. Augustine has managed to deliver on time, on cost, and always for the betterment of society. Or law number 31, the optimum committee has no members. And law number 36, the thickness of the proposal required to win a multi-million dollar contract is about 1 millimeter per $1 million. If all the proposals conforming to this standard were piled on top of each other at the bottom of the Grand Canyon, it would probably be a good idea. These two laws have at least one glaring exception, the Augustine Report, rising above the gathering storm. Following Mr. Augustine's remarks, we will have the opportunity to hear as well from some of our distinguished alumni, whose education at Caltech has provided the foundation for them to soar to success in disparate fields and occupations, but always sharing the values of intellectual fearlessness and generosity. It is a privilege to have each of you join us today, but first, Norm.
I would like to begin by congratulating each of you who's receiving your degree today, and to take note of the contributions of all those who have supported you. You can be assured that there is no finer diploma than one that has Caltech printed at the top. Further, you will always receive special attention as a member of the class of 2021 that earned its degrees under the extraordinarily trying times that surround a pandemic. Few classes before you have been called upon to summon the endurance, resilience, and grit that you've exhibited. As we gather remotely today, we better understand the words, "These are the best of times and these are the worst of times." Nonetheless, we have much to celebrate. A large part of the solutions to the challenges we will confront in the years ahead reside in the fields of science and technology. There have been a number of studies, two of which were the basis of Nobel Prizes, that found in the past half century or so, up to 85% of the growth in America's economy was attributed to advancements in just two closely related fields, science and technology. It is the strength of America's economy that will fund our efforts to confront climate change, deteriorating infrastructure, disease, and the chasms that exist in opportunity among peoples. You will be at the leading edge of such conquests. In preparation for today's remarks, I asked my wife of 59 years what thoughts I might offer that would be meaningful on such an auspicious occasion. And she counseled, well, whatever you do, don't try to sound intellectual or charming. Just be yourself. So with that in mind, it is the accepted role of a graduation speaker to offer a few pieces of sage advice. Now, to be honest, I can't recall what pieces of sage advice were offered by the speaker at my own graduation. I do recall that they were offered entirely in Latin, which of course was very inspirational to those of us who were receiving our degrees in engineering and the sciences. Today I'm going to offer just three pieces of advice that I have collected during my nearly 86 trips around the sun. For those of you who like numbers, that's over 50 billion miles of experience. Remember, I am a rocket scientist. First, there is a saying that life is what happens while you are making plans. I subscribe to the perspective of that great philosopher, Yogi Berra, who warned, if you don't know where you're going, you could end up somewhere else. But it's also important to take advantage of the opportunities that simply present themselves along the way. A colleague of mine liked to remind, when opportunity knocks, try to answer the door. The greatest regrets in life are not the opportunities that one pursues and fails, but are the opportunities one fails to pursue. Everyone is periodically confronted with decisions whether to remain in their comfort zone or, in the words of Robert Frost, to take the road less traveled. I hope you will consider the latter. Second, I'm told that at medical school graduations, it's common for the dean to announce something like the following. I'm sorry to inform you, but half of what we have taught you is wrong. The problem is that we don't know which half. And I'm afraid that medicine is not alone in suffering this affliction, which means that your long nights of study are not over. The alternative is to be professionally middle-aged a decade from now. I would note that in my own career, the first transfer orbit I calculated from Earth to Mars was performed using three sticks of wood and two pieces of glass, something called a slide rule. We have come a long way. Some folks have even suggested that graduation diplomas should have an expiration date printed on them. You may want to check the fine print on your diploma. At the time of my graduation, a common expression about something that was deemed to be impossible was, you could no more do that than fly to the moon. And just a decade later, I was playing a tiny role in helping place 12 people, most of whom would later become my friends, on the moon, and importantly, bringing them all back. Which reminds me of a conversation I had just before the launch from Cape Kennedy of the first astronaut who would fly untethered using a backpack built by our company. And I cautioned him not to have too much fun with the thruster controls, since I didn't want to be responsible for the first company to land a human on the sun. Without hesitation, he responded, "Don't worry, I'll land at night." And that brings us to the piece of advice you have all been awaiting. The last one. There's a country music song with the title, "Some Days You're the Windshield and Some Days You're the Bug." And I would hope that your life will be days of the windshield and that you will not have to encounter disappointment, failure, or even tragedy. My life has seen all three. What matters, as former GE CEO Jack Welch liked to say, is do you get back on your horse? Once again, my congratulations on what you've accomplished, and even more importantly, on what you will accomplish. And remember, the word commencement does not signify an end, but rather a beginning. Thank you for inviting me to be a part of this very special occasion.
Dear Techers, congratulations on this momentous accomplishment. I know that to get here today, there were obstacles to overcome, there were mountains you had to climb, there were problems that needed to be solved, and you did it. But I also have to tell you, this will not be the last time you face challenges. But the good news is that just as literature scholars say there are no new stories, I pose that there are no new challenges. Sure, there might be a different cast of characters, the scenery may be distinct, the plot may have some unique twist, but the problems that you learn to solve here will transfer. There will be skills that you've gained right here at Caltech. When you apply them to these new situations, you will come out on top. You will win. Wishing you all the best today and forever.
Congratulations, class of 2021. What a remarkable achievement. Any year to graduate from Caltech is an amazing thing, but this year in particular, you all have demonstrated that you can handle any challenge that is thrown your way. Doesn't matter what it is, where it comes from, you have the resources within you. You have the tools now to handle that challenge. This year has been an incredible one. The biggest thing that I have taken from this is that the world is capable of change, dramatic change, and that we all can be a part of that. And so I hope that's something that you'll take with you now that you have this incredible toolbox from all of your time that you spent here at Caltech, the many problem sets, the long hours. Now you can translate that into positive change for the world, no matter what you do, wherever your career or your future goals take you. So this is just the start. You're about to embark on a new chapter of your lives, and I am really excited to see what you all are capable of. So congratulations. Go forth and do amazing things. Can't wait to see it.
Congratulations, undergraduates. Congratulations, graduate students. Congratulations to the graduating class of Caltech 2021. Now the world awaits you. So what are the benefits of this experience that you've had? Caltech experience for me was one of the best experiences in my life. It just gave me that training that I feel I can do really much, almost anything I really want to do if I set my mind to it. Although the future for a lot of you all has some degree of uncertainty, and it's always uncertain for some of us, but one thing is guaranteed, your professional training will reap high returns on your investment, because you cannot decouple that branding of brain training that you get from Caltech. And my main advisor gave me a compass, actually a bow tie. And although I didn't get acclimated to the bow tie, I always remember that compass. And those wise words, Dr. Box, keep your focus and always remember you are a Caltech brand. And being a Caltech brand allows you to really, matriculate in really any environment, especially if your heart is into it, you are truly honorable about it, and you're honest about that craft. So I'll leave you all with great wishes and enjoy the ride, because it's gonna be a beautiful one. I graduated almost 16 years ago and I'm still enjoying the ride. Good luck in your future endeavors. And again, always remember, there is only one Caltech.
Hello, Caltech class of 2021. So back in the day when I was taking ACM 95 and the class average was about 40%, and I was passing entirely because the TAs were taking pity on me and giving me partial credit, I swore to myself that one day I would go back and learn differential equations properly. And so convinced I was that I would one day learn how to solve Bessel's equations that I carried those textbooks with me on 4 transcontinental moves, paying shipping costs every time. So I was very pleased to report that this year, 17 years after closing the blue book on ACM 95C, I have finally given away those textbooks because I have recognized that one day I will leave this earth without knowing what Green's function is actually for. And that's okay. I hope you come to that realization sooner than I did. Congratulations, class of 2021. Have a great time.
Caltech graduates, congratulations on making to this moment. I'm sure there have been times throughout your Caltech career where you've had a problem set or a research problem that you felt was truly insurmountable, where you struggled so hard before you finally found the answer and it clicked. Or maybe you never really found that perfect solution, but you had more knowledge and better tools along the way as a result. I remember one problem set that I spent 3 or 4 hours on, and I still couldn't get one problem, so the best I could do was submit a drawing of a pirate ship. The TA didn't really give me any points for it, as you can imagine, but he did draw some additional pirates to fill out the ship, so I guess that's something. My point is that I hope you don't just remember the satisfaction of getting the right answer in the end. I hope you truly cherish the struggle, that feeling of being lost or unsure before everything comes together and you get the right solution. Because understanding that struggle and knowing that not every problem can be knocked down easily is what will really set you apart and allow you to tackle challenges that other people will shy away from. Whenever I get that feeling in life after Caltech, I understand that it's not something to be feared. Instead, I realize that it just means that I'm truly challenging myself and pushing myself to new heights. So, no matter what path you've set for yourself, whether it's academia, industry, or entrepreneurship, remember those times of struggle and use them to boost your confidence, to give yourself the courage to tackle new challenges, or to set a new path for yourself entirely. Remember that feeling and use it to give yourself comfort when you're stepping out of your comfort zone. Thanks, and congratulations again to the Caltech graduating class of 2021.
I ask Vice President Kevin Gilmartin to present the candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Science. By the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of the California Institute of Technology, I confer upon you the degree of Bachelor of Science and admit you to all its rights, privileges, and responsibilities.
Thank you, Mr. President. As Vice President for Student Affairs, I am pleased to present these candidates for the degree of Bachelor of Science at the California Institute of Technology. Nyla Abney, Casey Adams, Sarah Wren Adams, Ashima Agarwal, Alessio Amaolo, Logan Apple, Nicholas Ardavin, Rahul Arun, Anthony Bao, Richard Bao, Rahil Buthwal, Brendan Berrigan, Samuel Addison Blazes, Ali Bubazari, Cole Braybeck, Liana Braun, Jack Briones, Crystal Brodsky, Kristen Brown, Michael Brown, Isabella Camplison, Cindy Tsao, Dominic Catanzaro, Andrew Chan, Christine Wingyin Chellicott, Eric Chen, Elsie Chen, Lucy Chen, Pavan Chitta, Jessica Choi, Nick Clausen, Joseph Como, Robert Alexander Corrado, Molly Crutto, Irene Crowell, Stephen Sapost, Alexander Tsui, Nicholas Caralt, Richard Joseph Dargan, Gianfranco De Castro, Daniel Delgado Cornejo, Vidya M. Dev, Kriti Devase Napathi, Jeremiah Dibble, Marcus Dominguez Kuhn, Khalidin Drango, Sergio Escobar, Elizabeth Gallmeyer, Thomas Gallup, Alexei Garcia, Dana Paige Gephardt, Mahi Gokuli, Rui Gonzalez Hermosillo, Jethan Gowda, Nora Gary Abdul Rahim Griffith, Sarisha Gadavali, Alex Guerra, Steve Guo, Arushi Gupta, Eric Hahn, Ryan Hahn, John Heath, Andrew Joseph Hess, Andrew Ho, Lofton Dylan Holder, Ankush Homeric Dutt, Laura Hu, Christy Huang, Johan Huang, Narice Huffman, Calvin Junsuk Ha, Mike Iovini, Tiffany Jager, Alex Genosi, Ethan Yashevsky, Mahek Jerez Tirceros, Qinshuan Jin, James Joseph, Jaeyoung Kang, Ishani Kermerker, Johanna Karas, Jack Berenson Ketchum, Olvira Khan, Esther Soen Kim, June Kim, Matthew Kim, Minjae Kim, Yujin Kim, Lily Kitagawa, Catherine Knox, Nora Eliza Coe, Adam Kogan, Katarina Koravina, Frank Coe, Sarah Kreider, Anthony James Kukavika, Sanjana Kulkarni, Vinayak Kumar,
Daniel D. Keim, Ty Lampkin, Alicia Lee, Regina Lee, Sue Min Lee, Yilam Lee, Yangyun Daniel Lee, Lexi Lamar, Amanda Lee, Michael Lee, Eric Leong, Sherry Leong, Rachel Lin, Tony Liu, Lauren Eleanor Liu, Serena Liu, Tegan Loveridge, Elaine Loewinger, Samuel Michael Lushtalk, Mohith Harish Manohara, Avery Marshall, Christina Marusco, Jack Maxfield, Liana Merck, Rohan Merchandani, Alessandra Mondello, Eric A. Moreno, Spencer Morgenfeld, Sichao Mu, Shiva Mudid, Izzy Muse, Aru Mukherjee, Maya Muttick, Albert Naziri, Daniel Niamati, Hale Obernulty, Ethan Ordentlick, Samuel Owen, Mayunk Pandey, James Park, Riley Matthew Patterson, Vivian Putworthon, Tanisha L. Pham, Tara Porter, Kenyon Prater, Sarita Pratuangtam, Cihao Chi, Emma Chan, Hongxin Chin, Brandon Quach, Natalie Schoenborn Ramirez, Anirudh Rangaswamy, Nathra Ravi Shankar, Malia Ribolo, Xinyi Ren, Jacob Ressler Craig, Paulina Ridland, Matthew Riker, Kevin Rosa, Ari Jacob Rosner, Daniel Rostovsev, Andrew Rothstein, Ankitha Reichel-Therry, Michael Klaus Ruprecht, Caleb Sander, Julian Sanders, Neil Doak Sanderson, Louis Santos, Sean Genuan, Aditi Shankar, Varun Shankar, Stephanie Shao, Tarini Singh, Whitney Walela Sloniker, Noah Sock, Maya Shrikanth, Gokul Srinivasa Raghavan. Alexandra Marie Stutt. Lauren Grace Suzaki. Haoyuan Sun. Jessica Sun. Rachel Sun. Sharni Sun. Yuchen Tang. Davis Tardif. Emily Thierstein. Charles Fisher Toot. Mikkel Tiffany. Kushal Tirumala. Allison Trussell. Albert Sang. Shufei Ung. Vignesh Varadarajan. Jamie Vinson. Jagath Vaithiswaran. James Douglas Walker III. Amy Wong. John Wong. Betty Wong. Stella Wong. Mitchell Watson. James Way. William Wurst. Ryan White. Katie Wong. Gabriel Wolves. David Wu. Sulan Wu. Yuanza Shea. Michael Yao. Dennis Yatunin. Angelina Yi. Jessica Yi. Akshay Yaluri. Christine Huishan Yu. Kevin Yu. Yu Chiao. Shuyu Yu. Matthew Zeitlin. Albert Zai. Isabella Zhang. Rebecca Zhang. Tina Zhang. David Zhang. Royun Zhang. Andrew Zhou. Angelica Zhou. Daniel Zhou. Xuan Zhu. Zemo Zhu. Alexander Zlakapa.
I ask Dean David C. Chan to present the candidates for the degree of Master of Science. By the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of the California Institute of Technology, I confer upon you the degree of Master of Science and admit you to all its rights, privileges, and responsibilities.
Thank you, Mr. President. As Dean of Graduate Studies, I am pleased to present these candidates who have fulfilled all requirements for the degree of Master of Science at the California Institute of Technology. Danica Janine Adams. Stephen Lowell Armstrong. Christopher Balzer. Holly Barnhart. Alexandra Rose Baumgart. Brent Roy Bellin. Jordan Benjamin. Benjamin Bernhardt. Sarah Blunt. David Broken Bonin. Alex Boozer, Maria Camarca, Razor Cao, Sharon Yinting Chen, Xiaoshen Chen, Costa Christopoulos, Ryan Kausner, Heather Leigh Curtis, Emily DeYoung, Hannah Dion Kirshner, Lillian Asia Dove, Danny Eppings, Bryce Edwards, Marguerite Epstein Martin, Bowen Gao, Ramon Gao, Michael Greklek McKeon, Ha Samu, Jinrei Ho, Wei Ho, Xu Chen Tuang, Yujar Wang, Hiroki Kaifu, Viraj Karambelkar, Armina Kapoor, Polina Hapikova, Korda Kilik, Songshi Kim, Sing Kim Kim, Ta Ho Kim, Tobias Kuna, Pranav Dhananjay Kulkarni, Tian Kao Le, Robert Liersch, Sola Li, Chen Li, Hao Yu Li, Ida Li, Zhe Hu Li, Wei Xing Li, Chen Duo Liu, Yang Liu, Yang Kai Liu, Ignacio Lopez Gomez, Chen Shren Liu, Tracy Liu, Heather Lucas, Elena Serena Lupu, Theodore Kenneth Massa Osi, Ren Thomas Marquez, Kelly McKinsey, Sophie Eve Miller, Oren Mizrahi, Jacob Morier, Daniel Mukasa, Sarah Edinger Murphy, Justin Anko Nim, Samir Nushabadi, Evan Hayes Nunez, Stephanie O'Gara, Yushu Pan, Henry Peterson, Catherine Plant, Sergey Poznov, Brendan Rasmussen, Ajashvi Rutella, Ryan Rubenza, Rashi Sharma, Chan Shin, Shaylin Nicole Silverman, Ratanan Siru Ratanagu, Michael Stramenga, Gregory Matthew Stroot, Ben Strzeski, Si Ming Soon, Yu Chun Sun, Chris Tang, Shin Tong, Audrey Wang, Christina Wang, He Ming Wang, Jiaxing Wang, Lin Wei Wang, Ryan Ward, Yi Bin Wei, Samantha Wu, Fengxia Zi, Tian Qi, Charles Shu, Natika Yalapali, Casey Yamamoto, Arki Yang, Yan Yang, Matthew Yao, Yuhan Yao, Gary Ye, Evan Ye, Zikun Yun, Dominic Jeffrey Yerk, Yang Chang, Hao Xue Chao, Chao Shi Ling, Xi Ran Zhao, Xu Yun Zhuang.
I asked Dean Chan to present the candidates for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy. You have completed the highest degree awarded by this institute. By the authority vested in me by the Board of Trustees of the California Institute of Technology, I confer upon you the degree of Doctor of Philosophy and admit you to all its rights, privileges, and responsibilities. I commend you on your high accomplishment and welcome you to the company of scholars.
For no fewer than 3 years of graduate residence, these candidates have made advanced studies and independent original investigations. These candidates, by passing a final oral examination and presenting the results of their research in a thesis, have satisfied the faculty that they have met all the requirements for the doctorate at the California Institute of Technology. Mr. President, I present these candidates for the degree of Doctor of Philosophy. I now invite the division chairs to present the doctoral graduates. For the Division of Biology and Biological Engineering, Professor Richard Murray.
Thank you. As chair of the Division of Biology and Biological Engineering, it is my pleasure to introduce Mohammed Abedi, Michael Altermat, Michael Anaya, Donna Pariah Bagarian, Avik Banerjee, Cynthia Mei Ling Chai, Hui Chu, Lucy Shin Chong, William Chor, Alexander Armand Cohen, Sarah Michelle Cohen, Shashank Gandhi, Xiaowei Wang, Jiyun Irizarry, Anders Matthew Knight, Joseph Marino, Reed Dillard McCardle, James Parkin, Elena Kim Perry, Porfirio Quintera Cadena, Tyler David Ross, Daniel Sawyer, Yodai Take, Zainab Turun, Greg Varujanyan, Rohan Wong. Wanrong Sandy Wong.
For the Division of Chemistry and Chemical Engineering, Professor Dennis Dougherty.
Thank you. As chair of the Division of Chemistry and Chemical Engineering, it is my pleasure to introduce Hannah Marie Allen, Charles Arnett, Jacob Bagley, Azur Iqbal Karim, Sophia Mohini Charun, Austin Ryan Delaney, Chiwat Linus Eng, Rachel Ray Ford, Philip Lawrence Helms, Karina I. Jetty, Paul Kempler, Heidi Klumpa, Weimong Stephanie Kong, Benjamin Lassetti, Sebastian Lee, Kira Sohun Lee, Griffin Mead, Joseph Messenger, Fa Nam Nittipon, Paul Nunez, Maiko Obana, Roberta Pochavichute, Christopher Elias Ryman, Ji-un Sheen, Ethan Simonoff, Gautam Dutta Strosiho, Chan Soon, Stephanie Denise Threet, Jingzhou Wan, Zachary Wu, Ellen Yan, Wiley Yu, Don Zhou, Wen Zhou.
For the Division of Engineering and Applied Science, Professor Ravi Ravichandran.
Thank you. As chair of the Division of Engineering and Applied Science, it's my pleasure to introduce Thomas Jeffrey Anderson, Noliaki Arai, Navid Azizan, Guillaume Beertzel, Pai Buwab Tong, Karina Sheen Kai, Yalu Chen, Yi Kai Chen, Richard Cheng, Bryce Edwards, Luisetta Vadimovna Elliott, Mohammed Sade Faraji Dana, Said Mohammed Reza Fatami, Philippos Philipsitsis, Matan Migosh Gal Katsiri, Leah Ginsburg, Soy Sharon Injetti, Silken Michelle Jones, Akshay Joshi, Gazala Kafai Shir Manash, Costantinos Karapi Perez, Kathleen Marie Kennedy, Arutin Kachaturian, Tae Young Kim, Deepan Kishore Kumar, Claire Dairon Guo, Danilo Similjon Kusanovic, Hyung Han Kwan, Anthony Herman Fukao Kwang, Joel Michael Lawson, Victoria Lee, Zachary Jordan Lee, Wei Xiang Lin, Palmer London, Wen Lone Ma, Riley Jean Murray, Yashwant Kumar Naka, Vinayak Narasimhan, K. Narita, Ellen Novoseller, Daniel Pastor, Antonio Pedivalano, Tung Pon Min, Ethan Pickering, Jenna Rare, Xin Ying Cindy Ren, Becky Rowe, Fabian Royer, Joe Roon, Faribors Salahi, Florian Schaefer, Shane Sharastani, Mesam Shamai, Bo Chiang Shen, Eric Shen, Shi Chen Shi, Jialin Song, Yu Su, Ying Shi Te, Ozon Teke, Simon Todley, He Ming Wang, D. Wu, Shaobin Xiong, Jian Su, Erika Ye, Hikmet Ildis, K. Yu, Haolu Jane Chang, Diwei Chang.
For the Division of Geology and Planetary Sciences, Professor John Grotzinger.
Thank you. As Chair of the Division of Geological and Planetary Sciences, it is my pleasure to introduce Elizabeth Bailey, Joseph Anthony Biasi, Grayson Lee Chadwick, Laura Chimiak, Seetung Fun, Alistair Thompson Hayden, Daniel Lee Johnson, Valère Lambier, Madeline Janine Lewis, Usha Lingappa, Kyle Metcalf, Sean W. A. Mullen, Alexandra Phillips, Kevin Roback, Leah Sabbath, Samantha Trumbo, Siwen Wong, Shunyi Wu, Hao Xia.
For the Division of the Humanities and Social Sciences, Professor Jean-Laurent Rosenthal.
Thank you. As Chair of the Division of the Humanities and Social Sciences, it is my pleasure to introduce Anastasia Buyalskaya, Xiaomin Li.
For the Division of Physics, Mathematics, and Astronomy, Professor Fiona Harrison.
Thank you. As Chair of the Division of Physics, Mathematics, and Astronomy, it is my pleasure to introduce Brent Roy Belland, Christopher David Bachenik, Kevin Brian Burge, Craig Cahillane, Swati Chaudhary, Chen Jian Ziang Kyle, Xu Yi Chen, Puria Dadwas, Kishale Day, Joshua Robert Frisch, Anna Ho, Ju Hyun Kim, Nian N. Lee, Joshua Lieber, Junyu Liu, Ivilo Madyarov, James Mangan, Zachary Mark, Muir James Morrison, Donal O'Sullivan, Aaron Perlman, Frank Rice, Brendan Roberts, Angad Singh, Lev Spodnieko, Eugene Tang, Yanjun Xu, Liang Yang, Lingfei Yi, Jean Ryan Yu, Minyang Yu, Zicai Zhang.
I now have the honor of presenting four special prizes. The first is the Mabel Beckman Prize. Named in memory of Caltech benefactor Mabel Beckman, the prize is awarded to a female student or students in recognition of academic excellence, leadership, and service to the Institute community. This year's recipients of the Mabel Beckman Prize are Arushi Gupta and Isabella Camplison. Arushi Gupta's contributions to the Institute and to her discipline will long outlast her undergraduate years. As chair of the Academics and Research Committee, she served as a liaison to faculty members and created a peer advising program in which first and second year students were matched with mentors in their options. More recently, in response to the COVID-19 pandemic, Arushi helped develop and aggregate educational resources, including a guide to long-distance collaboration. A recipient of the Olga Towski Todd Prize, she served as a math coach at Walter Reed Middle School and as a tutor with the Caltech Wise RISE program. Arushi graduates today with a degree in mathematics. Arushi, congratulations. Isabella Camplison's commitment to advocacy and service has helped engender a more welcoming, inclusive, and responsive campus environment. Isabella has served as president of the Caltech Feminist Club and Techers for a Sustainable Future, and as co-president of the Sexual Assault and Gender Equity Council. In these roles, she facilitated critical discussions on campus, as well as engagement with the broader community. In addition to her contributions as a health advocate, peer advocate, and Title IX and equity advocate, Isabella served as a tutor to Caltech classmates and to local students. She graduates today with a degree in computation and neural systems. Isabella, congratulations. We now move to the Frederick W. Heinrichs Jr. Memorial Award, which recognizes the senior who, in the opinion of the undergraduate deans, made the greatest contribution to the student body while at Caltech. This year's recipient of the Heinrichs Award is Varun Shankar. Vision, empathy, and resolve suffuse Varun's leadership and service. As president of the Associated Students of Caltech, Varun helped peers and administrators navigate the change and transition impelled by the COVID-19 pandemic. Off campus, He volunteered to conduct wellness check-in calls with seniors and to connect vulnerable community members to essential resources. Galvanized by efforts to address longstanding inequities in STEM, Varun helped launch the Caltech Community Mentors Program. In collaboration with the Caltech Y and the YMCA of Pasadena and Glendale, the program aims to help local students chart a course to higher education and to science and engineering. All the while, Varun has exemplified the ideals of a scholar athlete, leading Caltech's previously unranked tennis team to become number 21 in the nation and achieving personal success as a four-time All-American and academic All-American. Varun graduates today with a degree in biological engineering. Congratulations. Next, it is my pleasure to present the George W. Hausner Prize. The prize is awarded to seniors who have demonstrated excellence in scholarship and in the preparation of an outstanding piece of original research. This year's recipients of the Hausner Prize are Alexander Zlotkopa and Michael Yao. In a 2017 paper, experimental particle physicist Maria Spiropoulou and collaborators reported the first application of quantum computing to a particle physics problem. Within 2 years of joining Spiropoulou's group as an undergraduate researcher, Alexander Zlotkopa had expanded and improved upon that work with a research program that one advisor described as broad, successful, and groundbreaking. Alex is an author on 7 papers, with 4 more in progress. His recent projects have tackled problems in quantum computation and optimization. Demonstrating remarkable intellectual agility and ambition, Alex has brought his knowledge and technical ability to some of the most pressing challenges of the day, leading a campus-wide COVID-19 forecasting project driven by machine learning, and launching a causal inference study of racial inequality in judicial decisions. He has served as a volunteer tutor and as assistant concertmaster of the Caltech Orchestra. Alex graduates today with a degree in physics. He will continue his research on quantum computation at MIT. Alex, congratulations. Shortly after arriving on campus as a first-year student, Michael Yao requests an appointment with Professor Mikhail Shapiro to discuss potential research opportunities in his lab. Michael has worked with the Shapiro group since then, playing a leading role in new research area focused on engineering probiotic bacteria whose function inside the body can be controlled remotely using ultrasound. The goal of this work is to activate microbial therapy of the sort being developed clinically to treat certain cancers with high levels of precision, thereby reducing side effects. The depth of Michael's intellectual engagement is evidenced in his 2 publications and a 3rd manuscript in submission, as well as a provisional patent. Embodying the ideals of a citizen scientist, Michael has applied his interest in diagnostic and therapeutic technology to work with Atria Connect, a medical nonprofit he co-founded to bring training and handheld ultrasound tools to physicians in rural Haiti. Michael graduates today with a degree in physics and a minor in computer science. We wish him well as he moves on to University of Pennsylvania's MD-PhD program. Congratulations. Today's final award is the Milton and Francis Clauser Doctoral Prize. Awarded by vote of a faculty committee, the Clauser Prize is bestowed upon a student whose PhD thesis reflects extraordinary standards of quality, innovative research, and the potential for opening new avenues of thought and endeavor. This year's Clauser Prize will be conferred by the recipient's academic advisor.
Thank you. I'm David Anderson, the Seymour Benzer Professor of Biology and the Tian Chao and Chrissy Chen Leadership Chair in the Division of Biology and Biological Engineering. Thanks to the generosity of the Clauser family, we have two full Clauser Prize awardees. It is my great pleasure to announce the award of the first of these two Clauser Prizes to my student, Hui Vivian Chu, for her thesis entitled Neural Control of Male and Female Aggression in Drosophila. Males and females of many species fight differently, for example, in those where the males have antlers and the females do not. But does that mean that male and female brains encode anger and aggressiveness in different ways as well? Vivian set out to answer this question using the fruit fly Drosophila melanogaster, first introduced to neuroscience by Caltech Seymour Benzer in the 1960s. Male and female fruit flies fight very differently. Males lunge while females headbutt. Despite these sex differences in attack behavior, Vivian discovered a unique neuronal cell type that controls aggressiveness in both sexes, the first of its kind to be described in any animal. This cell, which Vivian named the CAP cell for common aggression promoting cell, connects to two sex-specific neuron types called MAP and FAP in males and females, which control lunging and headbutting, respectively. Do human males and females experience anger in the same way? There is no way to know. But Vivian's discoveries in the tiny fruit fly reveal that sex-specific behaviors that look outwardly very different can have a common origin in the brain. Vivian, it is my pleasure to tell you that you will be presented with a check for $3,000 in recognition of your outstanding contributions. Congratulations.
I'm Mansi Kastlival, an assistant professor of astronomy, and it is my great pleasure to announce the second Clauser Prize winner this year, Kisholoy Devi. Kisholoy's thesis was The Whisper and the Bang, Cosmic Fireworks in the Lives of Compact Binaries. Kisholoy helped build the very first wide field infrared surveyor, and it is now deployed at Palomar Observatory. The surveyor has opened an entirely new window into our universe. It has facilitated the study of cataclysmic white dwarfs, merging neutron stars, and now stellar mass black holes too. Kisholoy, you will be presented a check of $3,000 for this prize. Congratulations and all the very best.
One 100 years ago, the officers and faculty of Caltech stood on these steps. The graduates process from nearby Troop Hall, arrayed on the lawn in front of what is now Parsons Gates. 1921 was the first time our alma mater, Hail CIT, was sung, with grace and splendor bound. This class, early in the Institute's history, was composed of trailblazers like you. You have defined new directions. You have triumphed over daunting odds. Just as we were able to land a rover on Mars during this pandemic, you have demonstrated perseverance. You have demonstrated commitment. You have demonstrated support for your classmates. Niels Bohr, one of the founders of quantum theory, noted that it is difficult to make predictions, especially when they involve the future. What we do know is that because you are grounded in the history and values of Caltech, this commencement is a bright beginning. As Nobel laureate Dennis Gabor, the inventor of holography, points out, futures cannot be predicted, but they can be invented. You are the consummate inventors. You have the skills and the initiative and the confidence to make a difference. The final word goes to my favorite philosopher, Yogi Berra, as noted by Norm Augustine earlier today. If you don't know where you are going, you might wind up somewhere else. Exactly right. You are positioned to seize unexpected opportunities. It is how discoveries, scientific and personal, are made. I wish you magnificent new adventures to come and look forward to learning of the contributions that you make to science and society as Caltech's newest alums.
Welcome to the Mars Perseverance Mission Support Area. My name is Magdi Berra. I am the Uplink Mission Manager, and we are here with a message from Perseverance.
My name is Daniel Zayas. I'm the Downlink Mission Manager, and this message was received this morning. Congratulations to Caltech's 2021 graduates. Dare mighty things. This is Perseverance from the surface of Mars.
Congratulations, everyone.
Dear Caltech graduates.
Dear Caltech graduates.
Caltech graduates.
Caltech graduates.
Caltech graduates.
Your journey to this moment might not have been exactly what you expected.
But through it all, you have met new obstacles with grace
and grit.
You've challenged old conventions with courage and creativity.
With courage and creativity.
You have shared your own unique histories.
Histories and perspectives.
And in so doing, have left Caltech forever changed.
Forever changed and forever better.
We cannot all be together in person.
We cannot all be together in person.
We cannot all be together in person.
Yet together.
Yet together.
Together, we take pride in your accomplishments.
And stand in awe of your extraordinary potential.
Your fearlessness and your friendship.
Your ideas and your ingenuity will transform the future.
Congratulations, graduates.
Congratulations, graduates.
Congratulations, graduates.
Congratulations, graduates.
Congratulations, graduates.
Congratulations, graduates.
We can't wait to see where your journeys lead next.